So, over the course of the last few weeks, I've been building this isolation booth. Let's see how it came to be. I started off by applying a really thick piece of impact sound insulation to the floor where the booth will be standing. It's about 160 by 180 meters in size to comfortably fit an acoustic guitar player. The bottom is built like a basic waferboard wall, but with a layer of additional impact insulation between floorboards and frame. For cavity insulation I used Rockwool Sonorock 45mm thick and closed it up with a thin sheet of plywood and as few screws as possible to minimize structure-borne noise. After placing the bottom piece, I erected wooden beams with elbow connectors directly screwed onto the floor frames. Gaps are filled with silicon to make them as airtight as possible. I also applied silicon between beams and wallboards to use as few screws as possible while still keeping everything sturdy and leak-proof. After throwing up the outer wallboards, I pulled in the inner framework. The crossbars are connected with elbow connectors again and glued onto the outer wall with silicon. I had all the boards cut at my local hardware store. Unfortunately, there were a few bad fits and one piece even missing, so I had to fill in some uncomfortably large gaps with silicon as well. I then finished the frontal framework, and that's what the finished framing looks like. The ceiling is a thinner version of the bottom piece, also without any impact insulation. I shoved it in between booth walls and studio ceiling and attached surprise elbow connectors. And here comes the insulation. Electricity I wanted to keep as simple as possible. It's just a plug bar, a stage box and a screen cable. Those cables are laid through the wall for a bit to keep sound from leaking through the holes. They are buried under insulation like this. Because of the mentioned bad fits, I had to do some patchworking to finish the walls off. A few pieces of insulation needed to be pried in with a spatula. Beautiful, isn't it? Another layer of impact insulation before the carpet. After all, more is more. What I forgot to film before gluing on the foam, the inner wallboards are interconnected with elbow connectors. And here we can see the almost finished interior. 15 by 20 centimeters base straps around ceiling and every wall. 6 centimeter of foam for ceiling and wall, and the wall a singer will be facing, and 5 centimeter convoluted foam for everything else. Unfortunately, I had to get convoluted foam for monetary reasons, but it's not optimal. In the back is a diffuser made from pickets. Cheaper than anything else and works like a charm. Alright, what are we missing? We are missing some white canvas. As you can see, the ceiling is really ugly because I had quite a hard time getting those things to stick to the ceiling. I tried a few brands of spray glue, didn't work. I tried other normal, like universal glue, didn't work. In the end, I had to hot glue all those things to the wall. But I only own a really small hot glue gun. This thing, it doesn't work with large pieces of stuff. So what I'll be doing next is I'll be putting white canvas onto those white foam walls. This has not only aesthetical reasons but also practical reasons, because I'm speaking in this booth right now, and as you can hear, it sounds relatively damp, which is normal, but when putting a thin layer of reflective material on top of an absorber, it will reflect high end, so the overall sound will be a little bit brighter. And the door will probably, I will have to build a door, and this door will be subject of the next video. And I'll have to see if I need to install another one of those diffusers, or if I keep the door untreated, because an acoustic rule of thumb is treat about 50% of your wall with absorption. This is obviously more than 50%, so I will need to fiddle a little bit to make it sound as optimal as possible. Of course, this is a budget booth. It cost me, with everything, around 600 euros. And it was built with nothing but a handsaw and a screwdriver. So, I'm gonna try to get it as optimal as it gets. And on the next video, there will be some demonstrational material. Yeah, that's it for today. Take care.